Hello. Today we're on the Castlecliff Beach. We're here with our third year geology students, and you can see they're having a good time looking at the rocks. This really is some of the most spectacular geology in the world in terms of recording past sea level change. What we're looking at here is mudstone, very fine grained marine sediment that you'd find out on the shelf today, offshore from where we are, but this is old. This is 800,000 years old, this mudstone, and it was probably representing a water depth of about 100 meters. Okay, we go up and we see more mudstone, and then we come into this rather impressive shell bed. So we've gone from 100 meters water depth here to zero. The fossils in here live in the intertidal zone. They live pretty much at sea level on the beach. And you can see they're all smashed up. They've been reworked by waves. So this is an old shoreline where there was waves moving material around. We go up a bit higher and it's very sandy up here. And this is very shallow, sandy. And if we look further up, we start to get a few more shells, but progressively the sediments get deeper water again. They get finer grain. By the time we get 3 meters above my head, we're back in about 50 to 100 meters of water depth. So this is a classic sea level cycle where we've gone from deep water to the beach back to deep water again. Well, what it's telling us is sea level has been high and sea level has fallen again. And it's done that many times in the past. The rocks tell us that story. And what's special about this coastline is you can walk along it and you can see 20 sea level cycles that span the last million years or so. So what we're seeing is a window into Earth's sea level change. As sea level went up and down, it moved the shoreline backwards and forwards. You can think of it as sort of a tape recorder, a sedimentary tape recorder. These rocks are recording the changes in the shoreline as sea level went up and down. 800,000 years ago, this was underwater. So why is it now up? So what's happened is there's been uplift of the land. The land has gone up, and it's gone up just in the last few 100,000 years because of earthquakes and tectonic forces that have shaped the North Island. Okay, well, we're here in the Rangitikei River Valley. It's in flood at the moment. We're lucky to be sitting on this shell bed. It's absolutely spectacular. It's one of the most impressive shell beds in the whole of Whanganui Basin. It represents the time at which the earth cooled and the big ice sheets first formed on the northern hemisphere. So that was 2.5 million years ago. We're on a major river, the Rangatuki River, and it has been cutting through the cliffs here, and we really have a spectacular example of sediments that record sea level changes over the last 2.5 million years. It is the best place to go in the world to see the complete record of global sea level changes since the first glaciations began about 2.5 million years ago. So what does all this mean? 2.5 million years ago, this was the seafloor, and it was thriving with life. Now, one of the shells tells us that it was cold up here, and it marks the beginning of the Quaternary period of geological time. And what is special about the Quaternary? We had the first major glaciations of the Northern Hemisphere, and humans, our species, began to evolve. And so what caused the Northern Hemisphere glaciations was a natural fall in carbon dioxide. The planet cooled, big ice sheets formed on the Northern Hemisphere, and they've come and gone regularly. That is a natural rhythm over hundreds of thousands and millions of years in our climate system. So what's vitally important for us to know, what is the natural pattern? Where are we in the natural cycle, and where should we be heading? And we know that. We know that we are currently in an interglacial warm period, and within a few thousand years, we should be going back into another glaciation. Is the warming unusual in the context of the last few thousand years, millions of years? Absolutely. The amount of greenhouse gases and the temperature warming we've seen over the last century is unprecedented for 3 million years. We have not seen that level of greenhouse gas or that level of warming. Furthermore, if the warming continues, we are unable to naturally go back into another cold period. We now know that we've put enough carbon dioxide in the atmosphere that we can no longer go back into a natural ice age. So this is a very amazing thing humans have done through the burning of fossil fuels. We've warmed our climate to a state that we have changed the natural pattern of the ice ages and the interglacials. And that is said with 100% confidence by the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, based on the science, knowing what the world was like when we had more carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, and now knowing that we can no longer get it cold enough to have another glacial unless we get our emissions back to about 350 parts per million. Then we have a chance of restoring the natural balance, the natural rhythm of the ice ages. We, through all the greenhouse gases we have put in the atmosphere, have managed to take the Earth off its natural climate cycle, and now we're into a world we call the Anthropocene. Now we are the drivers of climate change. Humans are controlling what our future climate will look like.